him. Again, man, I saw me over and quit. Miss a pig.
Explain how this game lays. Plus with this fame, I got enemies, do anything to break me. My attitude changed, got to the point where I was driven. 24-7, money's my mission, just a nigga trying to make a living. These busted tricks don't want no mail. They spending their riches on scandalous bitches, so stay petrified of jail. It's hell, plus all the dealers want a meal ticket. Jealous ass bitches, player hating, but we still kick it. Always keep my eyes on the prize, watch the police. Seen so much murder, neighborhoods getting no sleep. But still, I get my money on major, continuously.
Hey, we out here grinding. SGT Chronicles in a special edition. A special edition of the SGT Chronicles. We're here at the 3105 Washington Road, making it happen. We wanted to go and give a little 411 on what we're doing. So, I'm here with some of the SUT members at the corporate office. And we want to know what we talked about the last time I was on live. And that was, what is your purpose? What is your purpose in life? What are you doing to make a difference in the community? What is you doing to make a difference in others' lives? What is your gift that has been given to you? That's what we want to know tonight. Sometimes things happen that holds us down. Some things happen that make you upset. You know, shout out to Sean and the Man Cave, talking about an important subject, especially for how men and their attitudes and their tempers and they flare up, you know. And I've seen so many guys throw it all away. That's one way that you can really mess things up for you. How you handle things. Spur of the moment things. So, tonight, we just want to ask, what is your purpose? What is your purpose in life? Are you heavy in the game? Are you making a difference? Whatever gifts that he gave you, are you turning it into something that is going to be remembered for a lifetime? That's the question that we want to know. So, I'm asking other things that I want to know. But what we're going to first talk about is service. How do you create an event? How do you make a difference? There's people always asking, you know, I don't know what to do, how to start. I don't know how to get involved. Then what you're going to ask yourself is, what do you want to do? What do you want to do in the community? You might want to do something that we have never done. What is your passion? Is it youth? Is it senior citizens? Is it government? Is it politics? Is it veterans? Is it cancer, illnesses? What is your passion? What gives you that thing that says, dang, you know what? I would do it this way. That's what you have to ask yourself. And then once you do that, then it's time to create a vision for it. What is your vision? A vision is a plan that you foresee for whatever you're trying to do. Meaning, if you are going to sell cupcakes, you have a vision on how you're going to sell those cupcakes, how they're going to look, how you're going to package them, how you're going to distribute them, how you're going to build clientele, those things. So, what is your vision of community outreach? What is your vision of the world? How do you think the world should be? How can you make any differences? What vision you have that will make a difference in the community? How? What do you have to do? What are your thoughts on it? How are you going to put a plan in place? Those are the things that you have to ask yourself. It's not going to come just like that. It's going to take time. You're going to fall on your face a couple times. But how are you going to move forward in this vision? We always say we are a brothers and sisters keeper. But are we really? I think we all can go on Facebook timeline and that's not the case. Why is that? Why do we hate so much? Is it because society feels that it's acceptable? Are we really our brothers and sisters keeper? That's what I'd like to know. Explain it. Why we are where we are. We only have one life to live. We only get one shot at it. And sometimes, during that one shot, we messing it up. I'm a product of that. But what are we going to do to change it? Or are we going to check out, not leaving anything to society? Are we going to check out saying, you know what? My life was not in vain. Each of us have goals in life. Is any of our goals has to do with you? You know, everybody tells you to write goals in life. Is any of your goals, your top five goals, don't have a direct effect about you? Warren Buffett said his goals in life was to become very, very, very wealthy. He had a few others on there, but one of them was interesting. It was to change millions of lives. To change millions of lives. How many of us can actually say we want to change millions of lives? How many of us? How many of us can actually say that they want to change millions of lives? Or are we taught to get in where we fit in, get it while the getting is good, and if we make it, cool, that's our only goal. If somebody else doesn't make it, oh well. Interesting. Very, very interesting. What is your thoughts on that? What is your thoughts on giving? Do you like to give? Some people don't like to give. I've had people say they got to get it like I get it. Or that's their business. Or I have to sacrifice. I can't sacrifice for that. You never know what a person's situation is. You never know why a person is in the situation that they're in. You don't know what their burden is. So who are we to judge the man standing there asking for a dollar? The woman out there selling her body? The kid in the store stealing? Not to say that they are all directed in a more disenfranchised way, but who's to know why they're doing what they're doing? Would a rich person steal a loaf of bread? Would a rich person stand on the corner and ask for a dollar? Would a rich woman sell her body? I think 98% of those times, the answer is no. So there has to be a reason why individuals get to that point. Not to give them the out. But like I tell everybody, I don't think no drug dealer wants to sell drugs. There's something there that is making them take that chance, because that's Russian roulette. You're taking a chance. So, we're going to get back to that question, because I'm going to keep answering that question. I get people that sends me emails, and I thank those people that send me emails and listening to the show, Simply United Radio, and all the shows. We're the community station. We welcome people to come in and carve their own niche, whatever type of show you want. Reach out to Ed as intended, Brown. But tonight, my question is, what is your purpose? What is your purpose besides the regular household, children, job, spiritual life? What's inside here that God has given you that you're supposed to share it with the masses? And it doesn't have to be community service.